Here is where my head is right now. I went to work today, and of course my friend, coworker Adriana asked me how things went last night, because when I last talked to her, I was going to find a place to sleep, because I did not want to sleep in that house last night. I did not want to sleep in a place I used to call home. But now my mother-in-law has made it perfectly clear that it is her house and I must keep it to her standards or I can find a new place to live. She said those words. I did not misunderstand those words. Whether she meant those words or not, you know she said them because she's thinking them. You know she said those because she's feeling them. Anyway, I was going to go to Adriana's house possibly last night if things were not somewhat resolved with my husband and his mother. But guess what? Things resolved in a way that means Crystal had to fold. Crystal had to lay flat on her back and let everybody run over her. So I went to work today and Adriana asked me how everything was and I'm like, it's all bullshit, but it's fine, I guess. I have to fake it. I have to pretend I accept it. I have to embrace it if I want what? If I want what? Why do I have to embrace it? What do I want out of this? Fucking place to live? No, thank you. I don't want it that badly. I don't need to accept this shit. Anyways, as you can tell, I'm still kind of upset about it. I called my grandma, because she called me after mailing me a check for $200. And she wanted to make sure I got it, and I said I did. Thank you. And then I said, hey, Grandma, let me ask you something real quick. And I proceeded to ask her about what she did and does as a mother-in-law, grandma, right? Because that was something my mother-in-law said to me. I call your grandma. Ask her. Ask her how much she loves you and what she would do for you. What? Are you kidding me? You really want me to call my grandma and ask her opinion about this? So I did. I asked my grandma about the situation, and I told her exactly what my mother-in-law told me last week at the hospital. I told her exactly what my mother-in-law did on Monday while I was at work with my kids all day. And I told my grandma what my mother-in-law did on Wednesday when I came home and found that she had cleaned my front room and went through the couches and cleaned under the couches and dusted, and that would have been wonderful had I, one, asked her for help, or two, maybe she was just doing it because she knows how stressed we are and she's trying to be kind. So that's what I asked her. Are you doing it because, why? Because I feel really embarrassed. Why, how can I get wrap my head around this? And no, she didn't do it to be kind. She did it because I have screwed with her son. The house is not to a level of to keep him healthy. The finances are not to a level to keep him stress-free. And therefore, his blood pressure is high because of me. Yes. And guess what? She wanted to make sure that she blames her son as well. And she made sure it's not just you. It's both of you. It's all of you. Your whole household is sloppy and lazy and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, mm-hmm. But when I'm depressed, nobody comes in and says, Jim, wake up. She's depressed because you're bossing her around and belittling her all the time, cursing at her, yelling at her, pulling her hair when she's trying to walk away. I mean, seriously, people, nobody comes in and says, Jim, you. Oh, and by the way, she sucks too. No, everyone says nothing. When Crystal's depressed and suicidal, nobody says anything. So now I'm focusing on my weight, focusing on my mental health, focusing on my marriage, focusing on my kids. And yes, I'm sorry, the house has come a little crazy. very, very dusty, super hairy, lots of clothes and toys and trash in nooks and crannies that we don't get to when we do a quick clean, right? But I do my best in the home I thought that was mine to be comfortable in. Now I'm not comfortable in her home. I am not comfortable in my husband's home. I do not want to call this place home anymore. So where my head is at right now is I want to find a home I can call my own. That's it. I'm done.